show. They, mm-hmm. We are so distracted.
Mm-hmm.
You must find your pure energy stream. You must get strong. You must have a good home. You must be financially secure. You must be selfish. So then you can become selfless, not the other way. They want you selfless.
Mm-hmm.
Think about when you put a candle on your birthday cake. What do you do once you sing happy birthday to yourself? What do you do with that candle?
You blow it out.
That's right. You extinguish your own flame. So every year on your birthday into this reality, you symbolically, you ritualistically blow out your own life.
Wow.
Now, isn't that interesting?
That is so interesting and so powerful.
All the things that we're taught to do, that we follow, that we have, we don't even know why we do, but
mm-hmm.
we do. And so it's really important to get back into your own pure energy stream, that connectedness with the God mind, that inner knowing. And all the other falls away. You don't have to participate in the outside world. Be aware of it. Don't stick your head under the sand like an ostrich.
Mm-hmm.
You don't even have to fight it, because fighting ties you to it. You just simply let it go. It is there, but I'm not participating in it. Hey, if my next-door neighbor needs to participate in it, it's not up to me to judge that lesson. Let him or her participate in it. I refuse to. I'm moving in, through, above, and beyond that. I'm going somewhere else. And that's what I feel I'm here to do. I'm here to move. I'm not here to stagnate and play in these people's sandbox. Let them go somewhere else. If I'm not going to play, if I'm not throwing sand back, they're going to get bored and they're going to go somewhere else too.
Now, at this moment in time, folks, you're listening to the Investigator's Report. I'm Gary Purifoy with my special guest, Mrs. Janet Swertlow, the other half of the Swertlow team, I might add again. And we're discussing God-mind thinking, if you've just joined us. And now we're coming close to the halfway point of our program, and we've covered so much already. This is amazing. But as we reflect on what we've talked about, because you touched on something, Janet, and I've mentioned this even in my conversations with people and in discussions and lectures and things, that if we were able to quantify God in our own mind for ourselves, as we see people, evangelicals do, well, the Bible says that God is omnipotent and omnipresent, and God is this, and the nature of God is that, and the God is. You know, we see so many people who go through seminary, who get their doctorates in theology, and they have all the knowledge in their head, and they seem to know everything that God is. But if the reality, if we were able to conceive who and what God really is in our minds, would he be God anymore? Or would he just be our own God?
I think that's a really good question, and I think that's one that people have talked about for as long as they have existed, is what exactly is it? It's kind of like, in my mind, I explain it this way. If I say to you, let's talk about a stomach, feeling hungry, feeling full, feeling empty, I talk about all those things. You understand what a stomach is because you have one. And if I say feel full, you know what that feels like. If I say you're going to feel sick,
mm-hmm.
you know what that feels like. It's the same thing with being within the God mind itself. When you get into that pure energy stream, and then you just know it, feel it, be it. Again, going back to linear logic versus multidimensional logic, it's not necessarily something that you can quantify in this linear world that we are in.
Mm-hmm.
Now, even we talk about linear time. Time really isn't linear. You know, time, everything exists in the eternal now. That's a hard concept for people to wrap their mind around. You know, I can say right now, okay, I'm on East Coast time. This is my present. But if I was in Europe, they'd be 5 hours ahead of me. If I was in Hawaii, they're 6 hours behind me. So really, the past, the present, and the future are all happening at the same time. That's kind of giving you a rough idea of multidimensional logic. And that's the same thing when we get into what is God mind itself. It's something you have to be in the middle of, you have to feel, you have to explore with each and every cell of your being. And that begins to give you a clue. Can you quantify it? Can you put it into words? Well, you have to remember that words themselves are extremely imperfect. If I say to somebody, how are you, and they say, fine, I don't pay any attention to their words. I take a look at their energy stream. I see what's really going on behind those words.
Mm-hmm.
Or if I ask them a certain question and they give me an answer, I don't believe that either. I don't believe anything anybody says to me. I read the energy behind it. I look at the energy stream.
Right.
So the same thing. How in words can we quantify something so massive and so magnificently beyond the scope of this reality? It encompasses more than this reality. So we're trying to quantify something that is beyond what we have, the current terminology and way to discuss it. The best way to get the clue of what it is, to be able to explain it, is just like the stomach. You've got to get in the middle of that frequency, and you have to know that you're in the middle of the frequency. Then we can discuss it with like minds. Other than that, it becomes a challenge that anybody could knock down. It's like saying, what's an elephant in the blind man? One's at the tail, one's at the trunk. Mm-hmm. You're both correct, but you have different perspectives. How do you describe that entire elephant if you're only on one end or the other?
So it could come down, it strictly depends upon the individual, everybody's experience and everybody's development within the God-mind framework is different from, everybody, like I said, everybody's an individual, no one's the same.
But it's all attributes to the correct answer of the whole.
Mm-hmm. And explain that so that I understand it.
Okay, if we talk about what's an elephant, because an elephant's big, and if you're a blind man, one person's on the trunk,
mm-hmm.
one person's on the tail, let's put a person on each foot and a person sitting on top of the head. And you say, what is an elephant? The one on the tail is going to describe it one way, the one on the trunk is going to describe
okay.
it one way, the one on top is one way, the one at the foot's another way. They're all correct. Nobody is wrong.
Gotcha.
But they're not, each person only has a piece of the whole.
The whole,
that's
right.
That's kind of what happens in this reality. Everybody has a piece of the whole, and instead of saying, I have a piece of the whole, they say, this is it, and I'm right.
Mm-hmm.
You can't say that. A toe of an elephant's more than the toe, an elephant's more than the tail. You have to all come together, because within the God mind, each one of us is just one cell of the God mind itself. And we are all trying to say, I have the answer. This is one cell. Well, we have a part of the answer. That's why we all come together. That's why the powers that be want to divide us.
Mm-hmm.
Because when we're divided, we can't put it together. We can't put the puzzle together. We can't have that complete answer. And in the totality of our existence, nobody is more right or more wrong.
Right.
And this also is linear. Who's above here? Who's below there? Everybody's got a specific station in life. If you're a garbage man, you're less respected than if you're a professor at a university. But who's more important? The person out there collecting garbage may be a lot more important to keeping this reality clean and neat.
Right.
But yet they don't get the same respect as a thinker. They're both equally important in the long run. And everybody, each cell within God's mind, each experience is equally important. When we put it together, we have the complete answer. When we teach our students, we don't say, we have all the answers, you come to us. We say, hey, the reason we have so many answers is because we have so many questions. And we are learning it, and we want to develop new questions. And if you can answer this question, you come and tell me, you teach me, you be the teacher now.
Mm-hmm.
I'm tired of teaching. You teach me. I'll sit back and learn for a while from your struggles, and
right.
so on and so forth. But in this reality, it's too much. Everybody's trying to be this on top dog, whereas we're all equally important. I can learn from everybody. Everybody can learn from me. And that's what teaches you what the totality of the God mind is. That begins to give you a clue when we all share, when we all put our pieces of the puzzle together.
Amen to that. And what you've just mentioned, Janice, in a nutshell, is simply what the mission of our work here on the Investigators Report is all about. We have different guests from different perspectives and different schools of thought and different experiences. But what we do here is that we educate our listenership and allow them to make their own decisions by allowing our guests to express and make their point and to present to them their part of the whole.
Absolutely, and that's the same thing that Stuart and I do with our work. We don't tell people we have so many questions. We have enough questions that we know that we don't
mm-hmm.
know everything. We know that there's a lot more to explore. We understand that you can learn from everybody, and whether it's the evangelical person thumping on the Bible saying, I have the answers,
mm-hmm.
I learn from them just as much as I learn from the person who's in their pure oversoul frequency knowing what's going on. Everyone has a part of the puzzle, and no one really is wrong. That would be a judgmental call. Everyone has an important experience. They have an important part of the God mind they're exploring. They're an important cell. And everything in the totality of all that exists. So let's observe it. Let's participate in what is important to us as an individual. But nobody is right or wrong. It is what it is.
Amen to that. Folks, you're listening to the Investigators Report. I'm Gary Purifoy with my special guest, Janet Swerdlow. And this is definitely a landmark program, because what we're discussing here is what this show is all about. As I mentioned several minutes earlier, to discussing and allowing different portions of the whole to come on board and to educate the listenership and giving different